Hey guys, what's going on? So we got a bit of a dark, more of a dark topic for this video. So I'm sure you guys all heard there was, specifically this one lady who was just brutally attacked by her then boyfriend, who, apparently 6'3", big dude, strong dude, nothing she could really do to defend herself. And she was showing pictures of like her body, what happened to her. I mean, she was just badly, badly beaten. Almost to the point where she had almost passed away. It's just a really sad story. And they had a women's committee about this in Ottawa yesterday. And I don't really have the proper words to tell you how much of a disgrace that committee was. The liberals, and I know this is some sort of a political attack, but these MPs who essentially hijacked this meeting were liberals and NDP MPs. She's telling her story, and the worst part of the story is that the dude who did it was found guilty, and all they gave him was a or all they gave her was a peace bond, basically saying, "Hey man, leave her alone, don't touch her anymore." That dude should be in jail, and the MP should have been outraged about this. But what do? They hijack the whole meeting. And I have a little clip here for you. It's just a couple minutes long, so we'll look at this and then we'll talk about it a little bit after.
We are born
Uh,
aware.
it's it's really just shameful what happens.
Relevance to the motion. Relevance to the motion. Absolutely, it is relevant to the motion. It is about a constant attack
This
on
is the
all
NDP of
members
MPs.
by the Conservative Party. We are leaving. We will not ever have, Madam Chair, or sorry, your mic is not on, and no one, and at this point we're not where we don't have space to acknowledge in this space right
So
now.
I want to acknowledge the witnesses, Madam Speaker, because I'm the one.
And the witnesses, the witnesses are no longer in the room.
Okay.
Leah, you still have the. Leah?
This is about collegiality. This is about using.
Point of order, Madam Chair.
A political agenda.
Collegiality is.
This is. This
point of order. Leah, we have a point of order. Leah, we have a point of order.
The witnesses have left status of women. And if we are collegial, I just think if we are focusing on women here, to resume here, they've actually turned their back and they've left. They were here to represent all women, which is what this committee
Correct.
is for. And the staggering stats that were recently released, and that is what's happened. And we need to get back to this. We need to get back to this testimony if we're going to help women in this country.
Let's vote. We'll get back to it. Point of order.
Okay, let's go.
Point of order, Madam Chair. Anna, point of order.
I think what we've done today is re-victimize these poor young women that came here to speak, not just on their behalf. She named multiple victims in her testimony, multiple victims. So it's not about just one victim, it's about multiple
and they were
victims.
Indigenous.
And Indigenous, well.
Yeah, so The lady who was on camera was the Liberal MP, and then they didn't show the Liberal MP. Sorry, the lady on camera was the NDP MP, and the head of the or one of the heads of the committees was the Liberal MP. And what they start this video didn't show that. I was going to show that video instead of this one, but I was just having some issues with it. So, but what they basically did is the woman who was abused, she made her testimony. And they just, the Liberal and NDP MPs just changed the subject. They then brought up a motion to vote on abortion, which wasn't even being talked about. And then the NDP MP comes out and she starts speaking about like other Indigenous women. And it's like this woman who got abused is here to mention her story along with other females who had gone through the same thing, including other Indigenous women. And she wouldn't even address it. And then all of a sudden she gets called out for her liberal NDP bullshit. And what happens? Oh, now it's a partisan attack. No, it's not. You just happen to be incompetent and liberal and NDP in the same time. Both of those things can be true. It doesn't mean it's a partisan attack. You're just incompetent. And it also happens to be that the entire Liberal and NDP cabinet is also incompetent. This woman was here to share her story and the egregious bullshit that happened to her, and the fact that the guy just gets off with it. He's got a young kid, apparently, too. And you know he's going to do it again. And again and again and again. And what do? We just go, eh, oh well, crime? Who cares about that? I made a video the other day about how much crime has been up. They also brought up statistics in a recent Stats Canada chart that showed that there's a woman getting strangled to death every day in this country. This is Canada. And Justin Trudeau and Jagmeet Singh and all their little minions don't give a shit that this is happening. And you know what? It's not even that they don't care. They want violent crime. Because there's no way they're this incompetent. And if this kind of stuff is happening in the country you run and you're not incompetent, that means it's happening on purpose, which means he is evil. 100% evil. All of them. I mean, the poor woman's parents were there too. I mean, they were just disgusted, as I would have been as well. I mean, this is just absolutely ridiculous. When you have this kind of stuff happening, people are committing violent crimes and then they're being just let go. No jail time, or even if they do face jail time, they're out on bail within a few days or a week. A woman getting strangled to death every day in this country. What do you even say about this? I mean, it's just... I mean, it's just... I'm not laughing at, like, this situation. I'm just laughing at how insane our government is. I'm just lost for words here. Like, what do you even say about these kind of stats and what this woman went through when no one is doing anything? Nobody with authority will help her. Her and her other, the other people that were there with her who were also have been abused. There was also like a woman's rights activist. There's a new term called femicide. And it's not like some woke term or anything like that. It's, there are women in this country who are being killed because they are women. As you see, the border is basically just wide open. And then there are people who are coming here from other countries who do not value female life nearly as much as a man's life. And they're coming over here and look what's starting to happen. It's not like this didn't ever happen before, but it was happening at a way less rate. And now a million people or so in the past years come in and look at the skyrocket in crime. Violent crime, and now against women too. Every day. And what are the Liberals and NDPs doing about it? Nothing. To the point where now these victims have basically moved out to California. I don't know why they choose California, but they're basically afraid to live in Canada. Because they know if something happens to them, nothing will happen to the perpetrator. We're just like, you're just seeing this country, with this beautiful country, just being destroyed in real time by our politicians. The last thing I'm going to say about this is that if you are a woman or a man and you see this kind of garbage and that you still want to vote for the NDP or the Liberals, now you got to question yourself, not just politically, but morally. Because we've heard all these years, oh, conservatives hate women. They don't care about women's rights. Really? You just hijacked this poor woman's meeting. Oh, because you care so much? Bullshit. It's just shocking. And I don't really even know what to say. I'd love to hear what your opinions are in the comment section. You know, what do you think the punishment for that kind of crime should be? I always love hearing your comments. I know this is a bit of a darker topic than what I usually cover, guys, and I apologize for that, but I mean, I just had to talk about it because it's just disgusting. This isn't even just about exposing Jagmeet Singh and Justin Trudeau's minions. This is just about what's happening to this country. It's being destroyed. Apparently, conservatives hate women, but when women are being attacked, it's the Liberals and NDPs who are doing nothing. They're staying silent. I'm sure they'll blame it on climate change or some other stupid bullshit that they'll say. You know, it won't be, oh, it's not my fault, it's the climate. Oh, it's, the conservatives, they were in 9 years ago and they messed up the country, not me. I didn't inherit a safe country, which he did. It's just, it's absolute nonsense. But anyway, that's, I don't want to repeat myself too much, and I really don't even want to talk about or think about this kind of stuff anymore, other than the fact that it needs to stop. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps grow this channel, and I appreciate each and every one of you who does that. Thanks so much for watching this video, and I will be back shortly with another one.